Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. SpaceX was supposed to launch the CSG-2 mission multiple times over the past week, but each time had to delay due to weather. In their latest tweet, they said, due to weather in Florida affecting pre-launch operations, now targeting Sunday, January 30th at 6:11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for launch of Cosmos SkyMed 2nd Generation FM2 from SLC-40. Taking a look at the upcoming Falcon 9 launches, we have a couple of missions expected to lift off in the next few days as well. As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Starlink 4-7 mission is expected to lift off tomorrow at 7:17 p.m. UTC or 2:17 p.m. Eastern Time. As well as that, you can see that the NROL 87 mission is expected to lift off on Wednesday 2nd at 4:37 p.m. UTC or 11:37 a.m. Eastern Time. There was an exciting article posted by The Verge saying SpaceX plans to launch a whopping 52 flights in 2022, and NASA's safety panel revealed today during a meeting. If successful, it would be the most launches the company has ever conducted in a single year, with its previous record last year at 31 launches. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. The work on the orbital launch mount continues. The orbital launch mount was also seen venting. Crews have been doing further work on the Starship Quick Disconnect arm. The claws of the Starship Quick Disconnect were seen being tested. The work on the new wide bay in the production yard continues. Sections of the wide bay continue to be assembled on the ground. The first section of the fourth wide bay level has been installed. The second section of this level has also been lifted and installed. A staircase section was seen lowered into the wide bay. There was an interesting article posted by Teslarati. It says, in a series of new job postings, SpaceX hinted at an unexpected desire to develop marine recovery systems for the Starship program. Michael Sheets posted a series of tweets related to SpaceX and NASA's HLS program. The first says, NASA's Aerospace Safety Advisory Panel says SpaceX this month provided the agency with an integrated master schedule on HLS Starship development. The next tweet said, NASA also conducted some visits to Boca Chica and Hawthorne that indicated there's been significant progress in the overall production of Starship and HLS. There was another tweet saying, SpaceX also gave NASA a good understanding of some of the challenges the company is having with Raptor engine production. Another one said, NASA's ASAP identified the required Starship cryofluid transfer management of refueling as a top risk to the HLS program. In addition, ASAP also identified landing technology's accuracy, stability, hazard avoidance as another top risk to HLS Starship. Some of the mitigations include the fact that there will be uncrewed test landings prior to the first human landing. The final tweet said, other Starship HLS risks include things like software and hardware integration, flight rate, hardware turnaround times, and reuse. NASA is working on all of those and trying to make sure that it's comfortable with the approach that is being proposed by SpaceX. Here's a view of the cargo door prototype ring stack and smooth nose cone. The booster upper dome was placed on the sleeving mount. The ring stack for this bulkhead was rolled out of the tent. The two pieces were then sleeved with one another to form another booster upper stack. Engineers were seen working on Starship 20's quick disconnect. Once again, taking a look at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, there are some dates for this coming week. Currently, there are dates scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 31st, Tuesday, February 1st, and Wednesday 2nd. Here's the Starship 22 body section being put together in the mid-bay. To finish up today's video, we once again have a Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. As always, thank you to Mary, known as Boca Chica Gal, and Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.